Students, welcome to class 7 mathematics chapter 1 integers part 2. So we have seen in the part 1 addition and subtraction of integers. Isn't it, children? Yes. But in that part 1, in the part 2, we are going to be study about multiplication and division of integers. So we are all excited to study this multiplication and division, right? Yes. But many of them having little scared. Why? Because many of them doesn't know the multiplication table. But children, the one thing you should be remember, multiplication table is very important for us to go in our everyday's life. Multiplication, addition, subtraction, division, all four operations are very, very important in our day-to-day life. So now let me show you one picture. So this is multiplication, 4 multiplied 3. So 4 multiplied 3. Can you just tell me what is that answer for 4 multiplied by 3? It's a 12. Yes, children, very good. So the answer will be for 4 multiplied by 3 will be 12. Yes. And next, let me show you the other picture. 9 multiplied 6. Just 9 multiplied 6. So what is the answer for 9 multiplied by 6? It's a 54. Exactly, children. And what about the answer for 1 multiplied by 2? It's a 2. Very good. What about the answer for 3 multiplied by 8? 24. Very good, children. Clap your hands. And so, now you would have observed here, so 9, 6 are 54. So, both the multiples 9 and 6 will be the positive number. If the two multiples will be the positive, definitely the product will be the positive. And here also, 1 and 2 is the positive multiples, definitely the answer will be also the positive. So here also 3 into 8 is there. So 3 multiplies by 8, which will be the 24, positive 24. So this is the positive multiples. And let us moving to the negative multiples. See, you have observed here two groups of minus 3 is equal to minus 6. See here, the first number will be the positive and second number will be the negative. So 2 multiplied minus 3. When you are multiplying this 2 into minus 3, the answer will be 2 threes are 6. And what about the symbol? It's a minus. Why it is minus, children? Because I already told you, if it is multiples will be both common signs will be having the positive. For example, if the multiples are positive, the result will be the positive. If the two multiples will be negative, definitely the result will be the positive. I told, right, if it is common sign, definitely that will be the positive. But here it is one positive, one negative, so the product will be the negative integer, which is minus 6. So this is multiplication with positive integers, positive and negative integers. So I hope you understand this one. So we'll be having some multiplication properties. What are all the multiplication properties, children, will be having? Commutative property, associative property, identity property and zero property. So first we are going to discuss about commutative property. Commutative property, which is nothing, it's similar to the addition and subtraction. See, here in addition it is a plus b is equal to b plus a. Like that, here this is multiplication, so we will be write a multiplied b is equal to b multiplied a. Am I clear? A multiplied b equal to c b multiplied a. So when you are changing the order of a and b, the result will be, the product will be same. For example, so a value, which is 3, and b value is 4. So when you are multiplying a into b, 3 into 4. So when you are multiplying b into a, 4 into 3. So 3 into 4 will be 12. 4 into 3 also will be a 12. So this will be the 12. So when you are changing the order of multiples, the result will be same. This is the commutative property. Coming to the associative property. Associative property, you can group the numbers in any combination. You can group the number in any combination, which means A into B into C. And in the second right hand side, A into B, into C. For example, in case A into B into C also we can be take, or else A into B into C. So when you are grouping, so if you are grouping the numbers in any combination, the result will be the same, which is associative property, right children? I hope you understand this commutative and associative property. Let me move to the identity property. Identity property, which is nothing, when you are multiplying one with any number, the result will be the same number, isn't it children? When you are multiplying one with any number, the result will be also a same number. For example, if you will be multiply 100 multiplied by 1, what about the answer? 100. Exactly children, like 5 multiplied by 1 is equal to 5. So when you are multiplying 1 with any number, the answer, the product will be the same number. This is the identity property. And coming to the zero property, zero property in the sense, so when you are multiplying 0 with any number, 0 with any number, the result will be 0. So 100 multiplies by 0, 0. 1000 multiplies by 0, 0. 1 multiplies by 0, 0. So this is the zero property. I hope you understand this multiplication properties. Now let me move to the division. Yes, so now we are going to be see division. So in that divisions also, we know that it's equally grouping, isn't it right children? Division is equally sharing or equally grouping. Yes, so as you see here, 4 divided by 2, so we have to be divide this 4 equally among two peoples, right children? 4 divided by 2, how can you share 4 equally to two peoples? Yes, so each one will be getting how much? It's a 2. So the answer for 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2. Yes, exactly children. And next, 5 divided by 1, so we have to be share this 5 as in a, we have to be share for 5 friends, we have to be share with the 1, so the answer will be 5. So similarly, 8 divided by 2, so 8 chocolates you have to be share equally among 2 students, right? So how much each one will be getting? 4, exactly. So like this here, 9 chocolates you have to be equally among 3 students. How you will be share? 3, each of them will be getting 3, isn't it? Yes. So as you are seeing, all the numbers will be the positive. So 4 also positive, the 2 also positive. So if both numbers is a positive, definitely the quotient will be the positive. See here, divide and divisor is a positive. Definitely the quotient also will be the positive. So I hope you understand this one, positive and negative. Now let me show you one more example. Yes, so minus 8 divided by minus 2 is equal to question mark. We have to be divide. So minus 8 chocolates are there, we have to be divide equally among 2 students, right children? So how can we divide? What is that answer? What is that result you will be getting? Yes, it is 4. Yes children, so each one will be getting 4. But is it a positive 4 or negative 4 children? Is it a positive or negative? Exactly, this is positive. How it is positive? Yes, it is because both the numbers will be the negative integers. If both will be the common sign, we can be right as in the positive answer. So I hope you clear this one. Next, I will be show you one example for you. So plus divided by plus. So when you are dividing any two numbers with the positive sign, the result will be the positive. So when you are dividing any two negative numbers, the result will be also positive. So when you are dividing one positive, one negative numbers, the result will be minus. So I hope you understand, same sign is equal to positive, different sign is equal to negative. This is a clue you can be remember. Same sign means positive, different sign means negative. So this will be applicable for multiplication also children, and the properties of integers. This is very important, the properties of integers. So properties of integers, so this is simple only. So for example, so if you are dividing any number, for example, if you are dividing 2 divided by 2, what is the answer you will be getting? Yes, it's a 1. So whatever the same number, if you are dividing both numerator and the denominator, the result will be a 1, which means A divided by A is equal to 1, 4 divided by 4 is equal to 1. 10 divided by 10 is equal to 1. Yes, children? Yes. And here, A divided by 1 is equal to A. So, if you are dividing any number by 1, the result will be the same number. Like multiplication. Multiplication, any number with the 1, the answer will be the same number. Like here, any number divided by 1, the result will be the A. Right, children? Yes. For example, 0 divided by any number. 0 divided by any number, the result will be 0. This is the third property. 0 divided by A is equal to 0. And AB divided by A is equal to B. So, AB divided by A in the sense, so if you are cancelling this A and this A, only the remaining is B. So, the answer will be B. So, we should not divide by 0 because that is undefined. Undefined. So, I hope you understand these concepts for multiplication and division of integers. Now we are going to see some workout problems on the board. So, children, in the next video, we will be see some workout problems on the board, which is multiplication and division of integers. So, thank you, students. So we can be seen in the next video.